والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. Islam
is forever. Bismillah, alhamdulillah. You're watching another episode of Beauties of Islam. I'm your host, Yusuf Estes, and today I wanted to talk about the subject of how beautiful it is when we can have faith and proof at the same time. I recall when I was first learning about Islam, I was actually trying to teach a Muslim about Christianity. And I was telling them, oh, look at Christianity. This is something good. Why don't you come be a Christian like us? And my friend, the Muslim, was saying to me, well, I will. I will go to your religion if your religion is better than my religion. I thought about that and I said, well, I guess we're going to have a new Christian now, because number one, in Christianity, it's very easy. You don't have to pray five times a day as a Christian. You don't have to fast the month of Ramadan. You don't have to pay any zakah. There are many, many things Muslims have to do that Christians don't have to do. But then he finished the sentence and he said to me, I will become whatever your religion is. If it's better than my religion, but you need proof. And I remember saying to him, proof? Proof? Religion's not about proof. Faith is just about believing. Just have faith. You don't need any proof. He said, well, in my religion, Islam, we have both. We have faith and we have proof. And I remember saying to him, how? You mean to tell me you can prove things? He said, yes, everything in Islam can be proven. Then I said, do you mean to sit there and tell me, as a Muslim, that you can prove there's God? Then he said to me, do you mean to sit there and tell me, as a Christian and a preacher, that you can't? Well, I had to think about that. Okay. So Islam is saying there's proof. Actually, more than that. Islam asks us to use our mind, our aql, to determine and find out things about the things around us. The things that we take for granted every day actually are a big part of what Islam is teaching us. Islam asks us, look around you, examine the things, think, use your mind, and then you will begin to understand. One of the examples that we have in Islam is the Quran. The Quran of Allah, this is His speech to the human beings. And He's telling us in the Quran over and over and over, look at this and look at that. Think about this. Ask about that. And then the answers that come. Often we find the term yasalunaka in the Quran. This means the people are asking Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, about something. And then Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty, He's giving the answers in His speech, the Quran. Always throughout Islam, as we're learning and teaching, we're coming back to this thing called the mind, the aql. You can use your mind. You can determine a lot of the things that you see around you, things that you take for granted every day. You can look to this, you can look to that, and begin to discover a whole new world around you. This is one of the beauties of Islam. I remember in the Quran, when I first read it the very first time, that it was telling me about this straight path. And I was thinking, what's that about? And here it is. You read it in the very opening of the Quran, in chapter 1, called Fatiha. There are only 7 verses. And listen to what it says. It says, Ihdina Siratu Mustaqim. Now we've talked about some of the other verses in the Quran, but today let's look at that. What does that mean? Ihdina. Well, Ihdi is coming from Hidayah or guidance. Ihdina, guide us. Sirat, this is a straight path. Mustaqim. And this means the straight path, which you're going to stay on this thing and you're going to go with it. How about the idea here that you've only asked for one thing out of 7 verses in this chapter? Only one thing you asked for, guidance. Because now this is showing you, for instance, that there's only one straight path, but many people could be on that path at the same time. Guide us to your straight path. And this is a request. We're making this request to Almighty Allah. We're asking Him to guide us. Now, watch what happens when we go into the next chapter. We go to the next chapter and it says, Alif, Lam, Mim. Dhalikul kitabu la raybafi. Hudil al-muttaqin. It says, that is the book, meaning the book of the law, wherein there's no doubt. There's no doubt. And then the word, huda, it means what? Guidance. The guidance to the straight path is right here in this book. Just a few verses after you ask for it, ihdina sirata mustaqim, here it comes, huda al-muttaqin. And what is muttaqin? It's those who are having taqwa. Taqwa for Allah. Now look at this word. And it's so beautiful when you know the Arabic language. The taqwa means to put a partition, a veil, a barrier between you and the punishment of Allah. So if the person is a believer in Allah and he's trying his best to please Allah and not displease Allah so as to not get Allah's anger on him, then this person, he's going to be on the guidance, the huda. Of course, when we talk about huda, that's a special word around here at Huda TV. We love that word. And it means guidance. And this is really what it's all about. I recall when I first came to Egypt, the very first time, and a friend of mine was a doctor, and I was going down to his place on the Nahr Nil, which is the Nile River. And he asked me a question. He said, can you tell us what it's like to go from some other religion, to go from what you were in before, to come into Islam? Could you tell us about it? I said, well, I don't know how I would describe something like that. And then I realized, I said, okay, I was looking at a boat in the water in the Nile River, the Nahr Nil. I said, there's one word I need from you. He said, what word? I said, the back of the boat, there's this thing you steer the boat. What do you call this? He said, Duffa. Duffa. What is Duffa? This is the thing in the back of the boat to steer. Okay. Now I can tell you. I said, imagine yourself now for a minute that you're out in the water, you're here in this boat, and you're blindfolded. And you can't hear. Something's in your ears, your eyes are closed, and you have no Duffa. You don't have a steering wheel. You're just in the boat. You feel the boat moving this way and that way and this way and that way. And you have no idea. And this is all you've ever known. Oh, you feel the wind. You feel the water if it rains. You feel the motion, but you don't know where you're going or why. And you have no idea what your purpose is to be there. Then suddenly one day somebody removes this blindfold from you. Somebody is taking this stuff out of your ears. You can see, you can hear, and most important, they're giving you the steering wheel, the duffa. Now, this is the difference. Because when you come to Islam, you can see, you can hear, and you have control. You have the control over your life. Now, by the way, just in case you didn't catch this, this is a good parallel because just because you have a steering wheel, just because you can see, just because you can hear, doesn't guarantee that you're going to go the right way, does it? No. But it sure gives you a head start over the guy who's sitting in another boat with his eyes closed, ears are plugged up, and he has no duffa. Make sense? Yeah. Makes a lot of sense. And that's what I want to come back to again and mention, that Islam has these beauties. And this one particular beauty where you're to use your mind and you can ask questions and you can get real answers. Answers that really, when you think about it, they make a lot of sense. You're not forced to just accept something that somebody says, just have faith, brother. Just have faith. Well, faith is great. If you've got something to base it on. If you can see something, you can hear something, and you have some control, some steering wheel, this is a great advantage. And it's probably one of the bigger attractions, I think, of all of the beauties of Islam that we've been talking about. I think this is one of the most emphatic of all of them. That it comes to you in a way that once you start using your mind and your heart, and then you see what Allah is having in front of you, it becomes a lot easier, a lot easier to accept and then to put into practice. All of this is just one of the many beauties of Islam. We've learned today some words. We've learned the word Huda. We know now Huda is guidance. We've got another word, Taqwa. We know Taqwa means to put a barrier or a partition between you, barrier between you and the punishment of Allah. And we know Ihdina, guide us to the straight path. Now Muslims, we say this 17 times a day. 17 times a day. Can you imagine that? In our prayers, because we pray in the morning, the noon, the afternoon, the evening, and the night prayers. And when we pray, we always include that in there. We say, guide us to the straight path. Ihdina siratal mustaqim. And that is the way to open it up and open this dialogue between us and Allah. And of course, that's going to be another one of our programs. We're going to talk about this dialogue that we have, another beauty of Islam. The beauties of Islam are many, and if we tried to enumerate them and count them, I think we would run out of time. And we're running out of time even now as I'm speaking to you. This program is too short. We wish we had more time to cover all of these beauties of Islam. And when we think about it and examine this brain that we have and realize that it was given to us, the knowledge that we have, that we're thinking with, this is all part of something in the Quran which we find. Allah says, يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ وَلَّا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ. Allah is telling us in the Quran clearly that He is the one that has all the knowledge. All the knowledge is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows everything of the creation around us, over us, under us. And we don't have any knowledge except the knowledge that He gives us. That's all we have. And He says that we only have what He gives us. And by the way, He can take it back. Have you not noticed what happens when people become old and they get these degenerative diseases of the mind like Alzheimer's? They can't remember things anymore. Their mind starts to go. Well, where did all that intelligence go that they had? Allah takes it back. So this knowledge, even the knowledge you and I have right now, that we're talking and you're listening and I'm saying something back and forth, all of this is from Allah. Maybe you'll remember it tomorrow. Maybe not. All of this is coming back to the thing we started with, talking about using the mind. And the mind is a very important part of understanding Islam. And it's an important part of the beauties of Islam. Allah asks us in the Quran so many times, using the expression, Alam tara kaifa. Don't they see how? Don't you notice how? Alam tara kaifa fa'ala rabbuka ashabal fil. Haven't you seen how your Lord dealt with the people of the elephant? This is one of the expressions Allah asks you. And He's asking you to use your brain, use your mind, think. So many times we've come to these beauties of Islam and we miss it. So I hope you don't miss it. I hope you will pay attention to this beautiful thing called the beauties of Islam. And watch our website too. We have the website, beautiesofislam.com, where you can see this program and others replayed. And always come back to Huda TV for more programs just like this. Until next time, this is Yusuf Estes reminding you about the beauties of Islam. Assalamu alaikum. Islam is beautiful.